the sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no country. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die.
Approached photographing John and Yoko for the cover of Rolling Stone was that they had been together for over 12 years, and that was the story. So I wanted both of them together in an embrace. And that picture was taken the afternoon that he was killed that night. He was shot that night. And John, you know, he didn't know the idea till I got there in the morning, and he got right into it. He said, no problem, you know. And that was John. You know, he was willing to go to extremes, you know, to express his point. And he was killed that night. He saw the Polaroids. He loved the Polaroids. He thought it really expressed his relationship with Yoko. And I promised, he was really afraid that the Rolling Stone wasn't going to run it on the cover, because he felt that Rolling Stone really just wanted to run him on the cover. He wasn't going to run Yoko, and I promised him it would be on the cover. So when he was killed that night, I pulled myself together the next morning and went into Rolling Stone, and they were already mocking up a cover for just his face, you know, on the cover. And I said, no way, you know, this is John Lennon, this is the way it's going to be. So we ran the shot of him naked. I thought it was also very brave of Rolling Stone to do that, you know.
Going back again. means to win. Come down and see me again.
When you actually decide to be a photographer, is such a different experience. You can be really creative artists using photography. I'm never tired of going to work, of going to take photographs. It's an adventure. I had the opportunity, I wanted to photograph Obama in his last days in office, and the White House kept putting off the shoot, and then finally it was like 2 weeks before he was supposed to leave the White House, and I get a call that I could come on Thursday at 2:00 the next week, and I said, that's the last day he's there, and it was just so moving to me to be there. The desk was cleared that night. They packed up their stuff, and it was inauguration the next day.
She's a good girl, loves her mama, loves Jesus in America too. She's a good girl, is crazy about Elvis, loves horses and her boyfriend too. And it's a long day living in Reseda, there's a freeway running through the yard, and I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart.
We never talked about cameras. We never talked. I'm so not a technical photographer. And what camera you?
What camera are you using?
What f-stop are you at? I mean, there are so many features on cameras now that are kind of amazing. The autofocus abilities now are amazing. But there are pictures that are not. There is either camera movement, not me. I wouldn't
There's no way I would shake. You want to take a picture? No, I'm just kidding.
Of course, I was worried about Anna Lou being with the Rolling Stones at the time.
My advice to her in the first place was, don't go on tour with the Rolling Stones.
It was such a seductive opportunity. You know, the world's greatest rock and roll band, they have the high life, rolling the dice at the top level, and you know, it was irresistible.
The thing is that the Stones pictures are so gorgeous this time, you know.
The thing is, we should have pictures like that all the time.
Shoot it, for sure, but don't go. I mean, I've got too many friends go on tour and come back drug addicts.
I didn't know what I was getting myself into. It was unbelievably stupid to pick that group of men in that situation to decide to sort of become part of something.
You know, we're all drugging it up and hanging out. My point was, go on some of it. Don't go on the whole thing at your own peril.
Photographers attached themselves to you. In those days, people didn't, were much more free and easy than they are now. They didn't mind, and no one asked, and no one cared, as long as they got on with everyone else. It was like, but, you know, it was okay.
She was one of the first female photographers that I remember. Well, it made a change from another bloke, you know. I mean, this is interesting, see how long she lasts. You know, that she hung in, and that was the other big surprise to him. He thought she won't last long, you know.
And frankly, I thought the situation was very destructive. I played to the most self-destructive elements in Annie. There's tons of drugs around. At that time, it was in their huge drug period.
I did everything you're supposed to do, you know, when you go on tour the Rolling Stones. You know, just imagine everything you can possibly do, and I did it.
We had a big tussle over disagreement about her doing that, which I was against.
Also, it was her idea, was it? I never knew whose idea. I thought it was maybe his idea, and he sort of said, you're assigned to this, or something like that. Okay.
But, you know, she got something out of it, and she's got a lifelong friendship with the Stones out of it, and a great reputation, you know. And she's, you know, was the, I guess by this point, just the unquestionably the number one photographer in our rock and roll world.
Have you done it so much that you could go in and blindfold and make cover photos for Rolling Stone and Mick Jagger?
I would never go into anything like you said, like what you just said. I mean, I wouldn't. I really take everything pretty seriously.
She certainly conveyed something from behind the stage or in the pit, and some which had never really been seen before. And the movement that she captured, I thought, was really fantastic.
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul and faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Made damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his face. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guessed my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. I watch with glee. Let me please introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth.